Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest has showcased his acting chops on shows like Orange is the New Black, Power, and Netflix Luke Cage. Now he's killing it on the silver screen in a new film, The First Purge.
Please welcome down to the circle, Jermel Howard. Yes. Hey. Hello, Jermel.
How are you?
Thank you so much for coming down to the circle.
Hello. We appreciate you.
Welcome.
All this melanin.
Okay.
All this melanin. How you doing?
Lots of melanin popping.
Yes.
Yes, yes. How goes it, sir?
Oh, wonderful. Great, great. Everything is moving, you know, at pace.
So, yeah, good. It is a blessing. Yeah. So we understand that music is your first love. Are you this person that always has something playing in the background?
Yes. I'm a big believer in frequency. You know, I believe frequency kind of influences you. So, you know, when something sad happens, you listen to a sad song, it makes you sadder.
Right.
You get on going out, you listen to your good music, you feel good. So I always have something for mood playing.
Yeah. What are you currently listening to?
I'm old school, classic. So I'm Tupac. Uh-huh. I listen to a lot of Busta Rhymes.
Oh, and, wow. Yeah.
Jay-Z, Nas, classic Nas.
Good stuff.
For some of us, hearing your name is the first.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So what was your first big break into acting?
Nice.
My first big break was The Brave One with Jodie Foster and Terrence Howard.
Mm-hmm.
And Jodie Foster was one of the highest paid actresses at the time. And Terrence Howard, who everybody knows from Empire. But I basically, that was the first thing I did. I jumped right into it, and it was a huge role for me to start with.
Yeah.
Usually a lot of people start with, like, being extra and stuff. I just jumped right into
Jodie Foster.
Right. She's a sweetheart, man. She's sweet. You know, first time I she kills me in the movie, and she was just felt uncomfortable for me.
Right.
You know, she's like,
are
you all right? You sure you okay?
Right.
You good? And she just kept, you know, being attentive. She's good. She's a good woman.
Good. Yeah. And then after that, Orange is the New Black, obviously.
Yes.
Luke Cage, The First Purge, Power.
I still get cursed out for Orange is the New Black.
Really?
Yeah. I'll be in the subway in New York, and the girls would be like, you ain't right. You left that girl and we get locked up.
Right. Just an actor, right?
Yeah, I'm like,
well, how does that make you feel when people respond to you according to your role?
No, it's good. Yeah. It's good. It's embarrassing if nobody else knows what's going on. You're on the train and then she's like, oh, yeah, you ain't no good, you know. So, and I'm looking like, the show.
Mm.
But it's good because it lets you know that you were believable when you were acting.
And how do you approach each role? Do you do it differently, or is there some something that you do for one that you don't do for the other?
How do you approach your preparation? It depends on, like, for instance, in the Marvel Luke Cage role, I kind of like went into the comic book and studied, you know, Luke Cage and people that were around him, and it kind of like gave me an idea of the mind frame of people that was around him at the time.
Okay.
So the character Shamik, he was like a homeboy that was like an opportunist that would hurt somebody just to get that $1 million. Mm-hmm, so it's a lot of people like that in America.
It's easy for you to transition to this new program project you're working it with. It's called The Purge.
It's
actually the fourth series of the franchise.
Yes.
Like, what is your frame of mind, and how did you approach this? Because this is basically giving people the license to kill.
Yes.
How did you approach this character, and what do you even think about that?
Yeah, I think that it's weird because we're in a weird position in America right now, and everybody's like, yo, that could happen, I think, you know. So it's kind of a weird, ominous feeling. But when I first approached the character, Zoe was like a lieutenant to the lead. You know, he's like his right hand, his most trusted. He can call me, yo, Zoe, something's going to happen, and I know what to do, or, you know how to execute something or clean up something or whatever. So he's supposed to be like his most trusted.
Yeah.
So I kind of like dipped into a few roles of people that were on side of Denzel and some of his movies and stuff like that, and just like watched a lot of that stuff and kind of educated myself on it on some side people that was like good right hand. So, and it's a big film because, you know, it's mostly African-American cast and director. Mm-hmm. You know, and we just went into 100 million.
Nice.
Wow,
yeah, we went
man.
To $100 million.
That's
yes, great. Yes, they did $100 million at the box office. So it's moving.
Moving.
People are definitely open to it.
Yeah.
I'm a little nervous of it because, you know, like I said, I think me, I think that something like that could be
right,
possible.
Right,
how I felt
right.
about it when I first saw it. I was like, this could happen.
Right. Right. And then what's funny is people always go to the killing, and crime is legal. So why not hit a bank first or something? Right. Why just go to killing automatically?
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So this is weird.
Yeah, well, before we let you go, mm-hmm. of course, Power
yes.
and 50 Cent. And you said it was humbling to work with 50.
Yes.
Why,
yes.
What was the experience like, and why are those your sentiments?
Yeah. Well, when you think of 50, you think of, you know, you see all the trolling and social media things going on.
Yes,
so you think,
50.
But when you meet him and he's real educated.
Mm-hmm.
He's a real educated person. Yeah. So and just running some ideas by him one time, and I just getting an opinion. He just freely gave me his opinion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I told him about something I wrote, and he was like, "Yeah, well, that's a good idea. I think because marketing, that'll be."
I like that invitation.
Right.
That's good.
So
that's
he gave me some good insight, man. So it was real humbling.
Right.
I didn't expect it to be that way, but he's an intelligent brother, and he'll give you insight.
Nice. Well,
yeah.
Jermel Howard,
yes.
We are so grateful that you came down
Thank
to
you.
Hang out with us
Thank
down
you.
The circle.
Yes.
We wish you all the success.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, the First Purge is in the theaters
right
now.
Right now.
The conversation
now.
Always continues on Sister Circle TV on all of our social platforms. Jermel Howard, everybody.
Yes. Thank you.